Amtrak's Southwest Chief runs between Chicago and Los Angeles and continues the tradition of passenger service started on this route by the Atchison, Topeka, and Santa Fe. Today, March 17, 1997, we've been invited aboard the Chief and Amtrak's General Electric-built P42 locomotive number 18 on its run from La Junta, Colorado to Albuquerque, New Mexico. This tape will cover the segment between Starvation Peak and Lamy, New Mexico. Along the way, engineers Dave Carroll and Randy Decker will offer some of their insights on the trip. You will see this railroad in its entirety, except for a few occasions where tape or battery changes interrupted the taping. We're passing by Chapelle Siding, which is adjacent to Starvation Peak. Ahead is an old Santa Fe steam locomotive water tank. We're on the Glorieta subdivision, which runs from Las Vegas to Dallas, New Mexico. The maximum speed limit for our train will be 79 miles per hour. There are two P42 locomotives on our train, and the second one, number 21, is giving us problems today as it is experiencing difficulty getting fuel from its fuel tanks. Although the maximum speed for this line is 79 miles per hour, we will be going quite a bit slower than that on this segment of our journey. One of the more interesting features of this line is the continued use of a multitude of semaphore signals. They are on borrowed time because the BNSF is replacing them with triple indication lights as they wear out. This upcoming set, which by the way is the same pair of semaphores shown lineside earlier in this program, are the last pair of semaphores that the Chief will encounter until after Lamy. This section of track was laid in 1878 and 1879 as part of the Santa Fe's push to California. In 1908, the Santa Fe opened what became known as the Belen Cutoff, or Southern Route, to provide faster freight service between Chicago and California as the grades in the South were not as severe. The route that we are riding today became known as the Santa Fe's Northern Route, or Passenger Line, as it was the preferred routing for Santa Fe passenger trains. Today, only the Southwest Chief remains to carry on this tradition. Today's Burlington Northern Santa Fe does run freight trains over this line, but not nearly as many as it does over the Southern routing. Our route in many places will be adjacent to the old Santa Fe Trail wagon route. We're climbing Glorieta Pass. At the moment, we're on a 1.7% ascending grade. Here at Blanchard, we encounter the first of several old searchlight signals, which are themselves on the endangered list. As engineer Dave just mentioned, we're on a downhill segment with a 1.4% descending grade. Along the side of the tracks, you will notice yellow signs. The ones with numbers on them are speed restrictions, with the one on the top being for passenger trains and the other being for freights. You will also on occasion see a sign that says ATS, which is short for automatic train stop, a feature on this line. If the engineer doesn't acknowledge the upcoming beep, the train will come to a stop. coming upon a unique part of this railroad where there are two horseshoe curves, one after the other.
Thank you. like on this side now. It's a daylight run both ways and summer all the way.
Yeah. Which is nice. It's not as much strain on you guys, I bet.
Clear. You were on this train when they burned that bridge, were you?
I made the cross.
Yeah.
Just before
that was
they
about
burned
a year ago, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Almost a year ago.
That bridge that you can see right there?
Mm-hmm.
They burned that down last year. A couple of kids playing with matches, playing with fire.
Somerville's got some great pictures that firemen took in sequence.
Uh-huh.
Oh, yeah. The timbers, the way they were, and then you can see the ties were burning when it was skeletonized.
Wow.
Boy, you really had some good shots.
How long was this line out of service?
It wasn't very long.
No.
They had to run it the next day.
Yeah.
They just built a little chute fly off to the side there.
Huh.
Went around it while they were placing the bridge.
When they said the bridge burned, I thought it was the one over the river.
Me too.
And that's when I thought they were going to be down for a while.
Well, I saw about a dozen kids, which you almost never see here, teenagers, walking towards that bridge when we went past.
Oh.
So I was sure it was that bridge.
Yeah.
That those guys had gotten down and tortured. Nope. Just a couple little 8-10-year-old kids. Well, they weren't very old. So the Santa Fe went out and killed their dog. They did too. Unintentionally.
With their equipment.
The dogs buried it under the bridge with a marker. Sad story all the way around.
Nope, oh, here's our dog that's always out on vigil here.
Well, if you could get to it, I'd have you chuck him a pizza.
Oh, I could. Can I give him a piece?
Go ahead. Gonna have to hurry. Let's see if you can land it.
We kind of log house, he's got him. Oh no, he's gonna make it.
He's what?
Throw it right by the doghouse? And he can't quite get to it.
You're kidding me.
Uh-huh.
You fiend.
I think if it could get into his house, he must have got tangled up there. He might get it. Oh, he went right for it, though.
We're now going upgrade again with a 1.5% grade.
Better give that dispatcher a call, let him know we had some engine problems.
station, I think, and just died again.
Yeah.
Yeah. That would be good. He's got a blowing smoke, and it goes away. That's blowing smoke.
Official title, road foreman right now or not? Or?
Acting. Well, it's smoke, but it's not doing anything. Speed now, aren't we?
Huh. Well, they can speed up the film when they do.
Oh, that's right.
Make it look like.
Run a little higher speed.
Due to the problems that we are having with the second unit, the crew is shutting down the head-end power that provides electricity to the train so that there will be more power available to pull the train up the heavy grade. Over the next few minutes, you will hear from the crew that the power has come on, then gone off again, before they finally give up and leave the HEP off until the summit is reached.
Sands of time.
safety, number three, over.
Yeah, the Amtrak 3, we're having trouble with the rear unit, 21. Losing the load on it.
We don't have that problem.
No, I don't.
I don't.
Is the head down too, Randy?
You talking to us?
Hello, Randy.
Go ahead.
Go ahead, over.
Yeah, we lose the head?
No, I shut it down in order to run it here. Did you get down with Randy?
No, okay, Dave. Go ahead and bring her up.
Bring her up.
Right there.
take a high colonic while you're at it. A high colonic? It's a cleansing agent. No. I thought maybe you had the same problem. It's been a week.
Santa Fe Railroad, milepost 809.2, no defect.
Bell ringing is yet another alarm coming from the bulky second unit. Now on a downhill segment of 1% for the next 5 miles.
Okay, dispatch, track one number one number 6900, $69,800. Located at 1521, 21. Dispatcher JSC, copy by Omega.
Thank you, Mr. Lamy. Number three there, Fox, over.
Main number three is Fox, okay. Thank you, number four.
Roger, come in, number three, you about to get the roll over.
What's my guy, over.
Alright, thanks, dispatcher.
Better keep us rolling, another one that sighting.
Pardon me?
You better keep us on the thing.
Okay, Dave.
Come on. Amtrak number three, hello, Ruben. Get some power back here.
Be patient, we're having problems here.
Roger, thank you, sir.
Here at Roe, we are entering a stretch of track governed by centralized traffic control, which will extend from here to Lamy. We also start our final climb to the summit of Glorieta Pass with an uphill grade of 1.7%.
Thank you.
Santa Fe Dispatcher Shop.
Fox sighting, we meet our counterpart, the eastbound Southwest Chief number 4.
Matter of fact, he's there, so.
Good on a roll by there, Wyman, and your markers are working. Roger, thank you, sir.
BNSF, going number 3, over.
Roger, DS, this is Carol. I'd like to get backtrack more at 69606.
69606, numbers 43, 1532. 1532 by Carol, over.
1532 by Carol, over.
Jack,
Over.
We're trying to get all out, but it's advising them that you're having engine trouble, over.
Roger, thank you.
Once he gets fuel in, it's going
to be... Dave, when we get over the passenger, go ahead and put the ham on that lead unit. This thing's just out of fuel.
Okay, Roger.
Okay, thank you, Dave.
All yours.
Copy that, the train there on the order, Dave.
Whatever.
Amtrak Florida, Amtrak P42.
Copy, Vegas.
Go ahead, over.
Yeah, Dave, we had that unit coming up on Friday, and it ran out of fuel down there about milepost 190.
What's the back one?
I guess that's what it is, over.
What's 21.
Is that 21, over?
21.
Okay.
Yeah, Tom, it purged it 2 or 3 times. It's just out of fuel.
It started one time, but it never started loading in any place, so we just left it alone. Once they filled it up again, it was okay.
Yeah, probably will be this time, too.
Okay, have a good one there, Dave. Number 4, Roger.
Roger it out. Phone transfer person.
They got that problem, then. Clear.
Yeah, they fixed that.
We're about to the summit of Glorieta Pass. We'll pass the old depot on the left, which is now the post office. Then engineer Randy will close the throttle, then put on the dynamic brakes.
This is track 169937, dated March 17, 97, Amtrak 18 West at Glorieta. Xbox 1, track word number 69925 is void. Xbox 2, proceed from Lamy to Waldo on main track. Xbox 8, hold main track and last name point. Copy, Mike Carroll, over.
Mr. Carroll,
Mike,
69937, okay, 1542. 1542, dispatcher JS3, over.
Glorieta Pass has been conquered, and now we're on a steep descending grade of 3%. Passengers get their head in tower and air conditioning back.
Let's see if it kills you again, Randy. Yeah, it did. Control breaker go out?
Nope.
Cool. It may come back on. It started to there just as I hit that thing. I didn't realize it until after I had. There you go.
Thank you.
Roger. Let me call you.
Thank you.
6M6 for flip support clear 1555. 1555, get on, over. That is correct, thank you.
Swimming hole here. And there won't be anybody swimming in it today. I wonder if there's a truck back there. Might be a bunch of truck back there. The water doesn't look like it's fit for swimming. As soon as we come around this rock cliff here on the left, that's where you can look back and see the Santa Fe Trail.
Okay.
But, this last stretch, we only lost about another 10 minutes or so. That was where I figured we'd really get with. With one engine.
Yeah.
It's the steepest grade we've got to run on. The rest of the way in town, we should do that.
So we got a man.
Well, piece of cake. We're over the hill.
What?
Oh, yeah. No problem. How's this one froze? I said it.
Come in for Lamy.
Coming into our station stop at Lamy, which will mark the end of this segment of cab ride along the Santa Fe Trail. Just past the depot, you'll notice the interchange on the right with the Santa Fe Southern Railroad, which now owns the old AT and SF branch to Santa Fe.
Actually, 37 minutes late. Without the 3 minutes, we're going to be about 40 minutes later.
Stop us when you get on, Jay.
Two cars up beyond.
I'm on platform number 3.
Whoa.